When Windows 11 was first announced, I made a video explaining how you should wait until the final operating system is actually released to the public. And on top of that, you should give it an additional 6 months before you consider installing Windows 11 on your personal PC. But in spite of all of that, a lot of you have been asking me if there's a way to upgrade and keep it safe, or can you roll back? Ultimately, you're trying to justify a reason why you can upgrade to Windows 11. So I decided that if you're going to upgrade to Windows 11 anyway, I might as well put a video out there to help you do it the right way and the safe way, so that you don't lose your data, you don't permanently mess up your PC, and that you have a way of rolling back in case things go wrong. Okay, so the very first thing that you need to do before upgrading to Windows 11 is back up all of your data. Either buy some additional external hard drives that you can put all of your data onto, or pay for additional cloud storage with Google or Microsoft OneDrive, anything that can store your data for you in case something goes wrong. This is a good practice to have regardless if you're upgrading to Windows 11 or not. So the very next thing that you need to do after backing up your data is check to see if your PC is even compatible with Windows 11 to begin with. Unfortunately, just because you have Windows 10 on your PC, it does not mean you will be able to install Windows 11. They have new requirements such as TPM 2.0, which is ran at the motherboard level. So first of all, your motherboard needs to support TPM 2.0. And then if it does support it, you may have to go into BIOS settings and actually manually turn it on. One thing you can do to make this process easier is download a program called Why Not Win 11, or Why Not Windows 11. The program looks a little bit sus, but I assure you it's totally safe and legitimate, and it will quickly analyze all of the hardware in your PC and let you know if you're missing any critical components in order to be compatible with Windows 11. If you don't feel comfortable running this program on your PC, then you can manually check the requirements on Microsoft's website and verify that your hardware meets all of the requirements. I will have a link in the description below where you can get the Why Not Win 11 application, and I will have a link in the description below where you can go manually look at all the requirements for Windows 11. Now, the next thing you need to do is download the official ISO provided by Microsoft for Windows 11. Do not download the leaked versions of Windows 11. What you want to do is get the official Microsoft release ISO file for Windows 11. Now, before you can download the ISO file, you have to become a Windows Insider Program member. Now, this is completely free of charge and the sign up is very fast. And I will have a link in the description below where you can download the ISO file. Once you're on that website, you will have to sign in and either sign up as a Windows Insider Program member, or it will authenticate that you already are a member. Then after you sign up, then you may have to go back to the link in the description below just so you can get back to that exact web page location so that you can download the ISO file. Now, once you've been authenticated to be a Windows Insider member, you can choose between a beta build of the ISO file or a developer build of the ISO file. The difference is that the developer build will have more features available. However, it is more buggy and therefore less stable. The beta build is the most recent stable version of Windows 11, and that would be the version that I would recommend you install. Once you download the ISO file, you should be able to double click the file and it will mount the image, and then a new Windows Explorer folder will open up with additional files on the inside. You're looking for the setup.exe file. You want to double click that file and proceed through the process of checking for PC compatibility as well as installing Windows 11 to your main hard drive. Now you will have a couple of different options to choose from. You can choose to keep all of your files and apps, or only certain files, or you can do a completely fresh install. Please keep in mind, if you do a fresh install, it will completely overwrite all of your data on your PC. So be very careful if that is the option you choose to go with. Now from there, you simply follow the on-screen instructions and go through the installation process just like you would any other normal Windows installation or any other software installation for that matter. If you don't have a Windows key, or if you don't know your Windows key, then you can simply skip that part of the installation and still proceed with installing Windows 11. But please note, eventually you will need to activate Windows 11. Either be prepared to look up your Windows key before the installation, or be prepared to buy a new Windows key. What if you don't feel comfortable installing Windows 11 on your main C drive? Well, there are two other alternatives that you have. The first option is that you can create a USB bootable drive with Windows 11, and you can take that USB drive and you can install it on a completely different computer somewhere or a completely fresh hard drive somewhere, anything you want to do really. All you need to do is to have a USB drive that has at least 8 gigabytes of free storage on it and put your Windows 11 ISO file on that drive. You will also need to use some type of program that will be able to make that USB drive mount the ISO image. And there are plenty of tutorials online for this, but one program that a lot of people use for this is a free program called Rufus. And I will also have a link in the description below where you can download Rufus and use that to make your USB bootable drive. The final option is that you can use a virtual machine. And this is what I personally did. If you're currently using Windows 10, then you can actually use something called Hyper-V if you already have a Windows 10 Pro or Enterprise Edition. But if you have a Student Edition or Home Edition, then this will not work for you. But you can also download an application called VirtualBox, which is a free virtual machine that allows you to do the exact same thing, which is install any software in a virtual environment. Now, the reason why you may want to do this is because you may want to tinker around with Windows 11, but not actually make it your main operating system at this time. But what happens if you decided to install Windows 11 to your main PC on your C drive and you decided that you now want to roll back to Windows 10? I'll have a link in the description below to the rollback steps that you can follow. But in short, here's what you need to do. Open the settings, click on system, click the recovery page on the right side under the recovery options section in the previous version of Windows settings, click the go back button. Select any of the reasons available, click the next button, click the no thanks button, click the next button again, the next button again, click the go back to earlier build button, and from there, you will now roll back to Windows 10. And essentially, that's everything that you need to know about Windows 11, from the installation process to the rollback process, and you even have a couple of different options of where to install it if you don't want to install it on your main PC. Well, I hope you found this helpful. If you did, please hit the like button. It goes a long way in helping me out. And let me know in the comments below if you decide to do this and what your experience was. I'm very curious to see how many people are liking Windows 11 so far. And until next time, E-Rock out.